So today we'll see what is Dudeney number. In your examination, you will see the question where a devil type question will come like this. What is Dudeney number? And your answer will be, you are unable to answer because you don't know what is Dudeney number. So first of all, we'll learn what is Dudeney number and how we can write this program and how we can understand it better with the help of your dry run. Stop this devil type of question only if you know what is the answer. So let's see how we are going to get the question. It says that write a program to check whether a given number is Dudeney number or not. Now how to check? First of all, it says that it is a positive integer. Now we know how to find it out whether a number is positive number or not. And next one says that it is a perfect cube. Now how to check whether a number is perfect cube or not? Already this video is available in your playlist number system. You can go and you can check it out. Now after that says that if it is a perfect number, then what we are going to do? Sum of its digit. We have to check this points. First of all, we have to check it is a positive integer or not. Then we'll check it is a perfect cube or not. If both are true, then we'll go for sum of its digit. We are quite comfortable with the sum of the digit. Now it says that equals to the sum of the digit is equals to cube root of the number. That means we have to calculate sum of the digit. We have to calculate cube of the number. Then we'll check if both are equal, then it is yes, Dudeney number. Now let's see an example. Suppose my number is 512. First of all, I will find it out the cube root of the number. We got 8. Now we'll find out the cube of 8. That is your 512. That means it is a perfect cube. Now if it is a perfect cube, then we'll find it out the sum of the digit. Now the sum of the digit is 8, which is equivalent to the cube root of the number 8. So that's why it is a Dudeney number. One more example. This time the number is 4913. Now what is the cube root? Cube root is just 17. What to find it out? Find out the cube. Now find out the cube of the 17 is your 4913. So it is a perfect cube. Now we have to find out the sum of the digit. That is your 17, which is equivalent to your cube root of the number. So that's why this is also your Dudeney number. Now let's see the process how we can do this. First of all, I need to accept a number. After accepting the number, I will store it in another variable. Now what is the need of storing the number in another variable? I will tell you when I will explain you the program. After this, I will check whether the number is a positive integer as well as perfect cube or not. Now why? Because the Dudeney number precondition says that it must be a positive integer and it must be a perfect cube. If it is not, I will display it is not a Dudeney number. After that, it is sure that the number is a positive number and it is also a perfect cube. So what I will do? I will calculate sum of the digit. After calculating sum of the digit, I will check if the sum of the digit is equals to the cube root of the user entered number, then it is the Dudeney number. If it is not, it's not a Dudeney number. So now it's time for programming. So first of all, I will declare a scanner class object. Scanner sc is equals to new scanner. We need to write system.in. System.in. So I will give a message system.out.print. Enter a number. Because unless until I will accept a number, I cannot calculate anything. So int no is equal to sc dot. What is the function? Next, int to accept an integer. Now, what are the prerequisite variables that I need? I need an original variable where I need to store the number, because when I will come out of the loop, the number will become 0. So I cannot display the number. So that's why I'm keeping a backup of the number. So OR is equal to NO. I need sum is equals to 0, because I need to calculate sum of the digit. Initial value must be 0. So that's all in the meantime. So after this, what I need to check, I need to find it out the cube root of the number. So suppose I am taking a variable called CB is equal to, I have to convert it into integer, because math dot square root, math dot pow, math dot CBRT, every function gives me the result in the form of double. Again, I have to find out the rounded value of the number. Why I need to get the rounded value of the number? Because it will give in a fraction. Suppose I am saying square root of 5. So that means some decimal 5 or 6 decimal places will come. So that's why I will make it round up to the nearest integer. Now after that I will say math dot, yes, CBRT function is used to find out the cube root of the number. So the number is stored in NO, so that's why I will say NO. Once I got the cube root, what I will do, I will check if the number is your positive integer. That means if NO is greater than 0 for the positive, as well as the number is a perfect cube or not. How to check the perfect cube or not? Suppose I have entered 125. The square root of the 125 is your 5. Now, if I am making a reverse operation, that is called 5 into 5 into 5, I am getting 125 again. So that means it is a perfect cube. So with this example, what we need to do? The cube root is available in CB. So what I will say? I will say CB into CB into CB. That means cube of the cube root is equal to the number. Look at over here. This is your CB, CB into CB into CB. That is your cube is equals to your original number. Now you might be thinking that, sir, why you are doing CB into CB into CB? Why not you are using math.pow? Again, it will return the result in the form of double. I have to convert it into integer. In order to avoid that, I am just using the multiplication. Now, if it is true, that means the number is positive integer as well as perfect cube. That means I need to find out sum of the digit. How to find out sum of the digit? While nahi aata hai aapko how to find out sum of the digit, go to the Play Store number system. There you will get a video called Single Logic for 5 Programs, where you will get the logic to find out sum of the digit. So while number is greater than 0, I will get the reminder. I will say int r is equal to NO modulo 10. After that, I will calculate the sum. Sum is equal to sum plus your remainder. Then I will reduce the number. Number is equal to number by 10. Now, after this, I will get the sum of the digit. Now, what it is saying, check if your sum of the digit is equals to cube root of the number. Cube root of the number is stored in CB. Here we have stored the cube root of the number, CB. So that's why I'm checking if sum is equals to cube root of the number, then I will display system.out.print NO is, if it is equal, then number is a Dudeney number, Dudeney number. Otherwise, it is not a Dudeney number. Else NO is not a Dudeney number. But when I will come out of this loop, if this loop is false, then obviously, it is either a negative number or it is not a perfect cube. Also, it is not a Dudeney number. So, that means I have to display the same message over here. Else the number is not a Dudeney number. But we have a logical error over here. You will tell me where the logical error is. Let me run this. Now, suppose I am giving 512. Now, 0 is a Dudeney number. It should display 512 is a Dudeney number. Now, check it out where we did the mistake. As I told you, when I will come out of this loop, my number will become 0. That's why in your output, we are getting 0 is Dudeney number. So, because of that reason, I have stored the number in a variable called OR. Now, what we need to do? We need to store this in another variable which is going to be used over here. So that means here I am going to use OR, and instead of NO, I will use OR. In every places, instead of NO, I will use OR. Now, let's run this to show you. Now, I'm giving 512. Now, I got 512 is a Dudeney number. Let's run this again. Give a minus number, minus 125. Look at 125 is not a Dudeney number because it is negative. Now, again, I'm giving plus 125 is not a Dudeney number. Now, let's stress on another one. How many times I need to write if else and all your display statement? Now, we need to learn how to reduce the code. Now, here I am using flag is equals to minus 1, where I am considering this one is for not a Dudeney number. Now, inside this I am saying if your sum is equal to cube root of the number, it is a Dudeney number. So, I am saying f is equal to 1. That means f is equal to minus 1 is for not a Dudeney number, and f is equal to 1 is for your Dudeney number. So, only I need to check once over here, that is if my f is equals to minus 1, then display is not a Dudeney number, is not a Dudeney number. Otherwise, I will say OR is a Dudeney number. Okay, let's run this again. Now again, I'm giving 512, is displaying 512 is a Dudeney number. Now we have reduced number of display statement, number of else also. Now I'm saying 786. 786 is not a Dudeney number. So, these are the way. If you learn the program, then you can reduce the code also. First of all, learn how to write the program. Then we can reduce the code also.